The name diptera derived from the Greek words di meaning two and ptera meaning wings refers to the fact that true flies have only a single pair of wings. Diptera means two wings and true flies bear only one pair of functional wings. The hind wings are reduced to small club-shaped structures called halters. Only the membranous front wing are used in flight. The halters help the insect maintain balance. All flies have piercing, sucking, sponging mouthparts. All larvae are legless. Insect order Diptera consists of the insect community insects commonly known as true flies, mosquitoes, midges, and gnats. This order is made up of 130 families that contain over 98,000 species. Although it is not the largest order of insects, Diptera is definitely the most infamous thanks in part to the mosquito and fly species that it contains. The Greek words di and ptera translate to two wings, which describes the number of wings found on species belonging to the order Diptera. Unlike other insects like bees and wasps, which have four wings, flies, mosquitoes, gnats, and midges only have two wings that they are able to use for flight. Their remaining two wings have been reduced to club-like appendages, which are known as halters, are useless for flight but instead are used to maintain balance while the insect is flying. It is the presence of two wings rather than four that define a fly or other insect belonging to this order from other winged insects. All members of Diptera share, besides having two wings, is that they all go through complete metamorphosis, that is, egg, larva, pupa, adult. The larva of Diptera differs from other insects as that they are legless and will either have a head with chewing mouth parts, quilliciform, or no head with only rudimentary mouth hooks for feeding, vermiform. Quilliciform type larvae are typically in mosquitoes, while vermiform type larvae are typically in true flies and are commonly referred to as maggots. All Diptera larvae live in aquatic or moist environments where they feed on plants and animal material. The order Diptera is split into two suborders, which are Nematocera and Brachycera. Nematocera includes the fine-bodied flies with long antenna such as mosquitoes, crane flies, and midges. Brachycera includes the flies that are thicker in body size and have shorter antenna such as house flies, horse flies, and rubber flies. Families of Diptera can also be categorized into groups based on their behavior and their lifestyle. There are five main categories, which include biting flies, the herbivores, scavengers, predators, and parasites. The biting fly group consists of all of the flies that are able to pierce and bite using mouth parts that are adapted to do so. This group includes mosquitoes, horse flies, black flies, moth flies, noceums, and the common house flies. The herbivorous group is made up of the flies whose larvae eat plant material. The scavenger group includes species that feed off of rotting and decomposing water or other organic matter found in soil or dung during their larval stage. Crane flies, blow flies, promase flies, and flesh flies are all part of this group. The predatory species prey on other insects as either adults or larva. Flies belonging to this group include rubber flies, dance flies, bee flies and flower flies. The parasitic group parasitize other organisms internally or externally as larvae or adults. This group includes marsh flies, bot flies and louse flies. All of these groups share the common characteristics of the order Diptera. With their similar body and wing structure and complete life cycle of metamorphosis, because of many similarities that the members of this order share, many species of flies are extremely adaptable and can be found globally in every corner of the earth. As long as they are able to find a suitable food source for the larva to feed from, flies will be able to survive and thrive just about anywhere. Although many species are regarded as pests and disease carriers, there are flies that serve as important pollinators for many crops. Adult flies live in a wide range of habitats and display enormous variation in appearance and lifestyle. In many families, the proboscis, that is the rostrum, is adapted for sponging and are lapping. These flies survive on honeydew, nectar or the exudates of various plants and animals, dead or alive. In other families, the proboscis is adapted for cutting or piercing the tissues of the host. Mosquitoes transmit diseases to humans and domestic animals. Few dipteran species damage land space plants. In greenhouses, fungus gants damage roots and may vector root diseases. Many flies are beneficial since they pollinate flowers, are predators and are parasitoids. Coming to the biting flies, in most cases only the adult females take blood meal. Mosquitoes, family Culicidae, may spread malaria, elephantiasis, yellow fever, filariasis and other diseases. Horse flies or deer flies may spread tularemia, loeasis, trypanosomiasis and other diseases. Black flies, family Similidae, may spread human onchocerciasis and leukocytosis infections of poultry. Moth flies, family Physocidae, may spread leishmaniasis, sand fly fever and other diseases. House flies, family Muscidae. These are among the most cosmopolitan of all insects. Some species have biting mouthparts, others are merely scavengers. Diseases such as dysentery, cholera and yawns may be transmitted on their feet and mouthparts. Herbivores, larvae feed on plant tissues. Gall midges, some induce the formation of plant galls, others are scavengers, predators or parasites. Fruit flies, many species are agricultural pests such as apple maggot, Regolites pomonilla, leaf miners. Most larvae are leaf miners, some are stem and seed borers. Several species are agricultural pests. Scavengers, larvae feed in dung, carrion, garbage or other organic matter. Crane flies, larvae live in soil or mud. Blow flies, larvae feed on garbage and carrion, includes the screwworm, Clesomyra hemineorax. Flesh flies, family Sarcophagidae, larvae typically feed on carrion. Some species may cause human miasis. Predators, adults and our larvae attack other insects as prey. Robber flies, family Acylidae, general predators of other insects. Bee flies, family Bombylidae, predatory larvae, adult bee mimics. Dance flies, adults are predatory. Flowers flies, some larvae are aphid predators and most adults mimic bees or wasps. Parasites. Larvae are parasites or parasitoids of other animals. Several species are important biocontrol agents. March flies. Larvae parasitize slugs and flies. Bot flies are warble flies. Family Osteridae. Larvae are endoparasites of mammals including humans. Loose flies. Family Hippobosidae. Adults are blood feeding ectoparasites of birds and animals. Coming to the description of dipterans, as the name Diptera indicates, most true flies have just one pair of functional wings. A pair of modified wings called halters replace the hind wings. The halters connected to a nerve filled socket and work much like a gyroscope to keep the fly on course and stabilize its flight. Most dipterans use sponging mouthparts to lap juices from fruits, nectar or fluids exuded from animals. If you have ever encountered a horse or deer fly, you probably know that other flies have piercing, biting mouthparts to feed on the blood of vertebrate hosts. Flies have larger compound eyes. True flies live in abundance worldwide. Though their larvae generally require a moist environment, some kind of scientists describe over 120,000 species in this order. Coming to the major families in this order, Culicidae, mosquitoes, Tipulidae, crane flies, Similidae, black flies, Muscididae, house flies, Cicidomidae, gall midges, Calliphoridae, blowflies, Drosophilidae, pomace flies. Flies are minute to large insects, about 0.05 to 60 millimeter long, extremely variable in form and color, but are mostly rather soft bodied flying forms. The compound eyes are usually large, often occupying most of the head. They may meet on the top of the head or may be well separated often. In the same species, the males show the former condition, the females the later one. The antennae are extremely variable in form and consist of 3 to 4 faulty segments. Diptera are primarily aerial insects, and the mesothorax, which bears the only pair of wings, has come to dominate the thorax. The legs are normally rather simple and are used primarily for preaching. In some groups, they are modified for prey capture or for signaling during courtship. The tarsi are nearly always 5 segmented. The functional wings are membranous and their pattern of veins is critical in fly classification and identification. During the evolution of flies, there has been a trend towards a reduction in veins, especially in the rear of the wing changes that evidently relate to improvements in two-winged flight. The hind wings present in most other insects are reduced in Diptera to small club-like organs called halters used for stabilizing flight. Flies are holometabolous insects and the larvae typically live completely different lives than the adult insects do. The larvae eat to grow and to provide reserves for adult activity. The adult is primarily a reproductive and dispersal stage. The larvae never have joint thoracic legs, but sometimes have fleshy prolegs or pseudopods that allow them to move by pushing against surfaces around them. Nematocerian species usually have a complete well-sclerotized head capsule, but this is reduced drastically in the maggots of higher Diptera to an internal skeleton supporting the hooked mandibles and pharynx. The pupa is usually immobile, although those of some aquatic Nematocera, example mosquitoes, actively swim. About 150,000 species of living diptera have been described approximately. Apart from that, 10,000 genera and 150 families. This is about 14% of the world's known insect fauna. The true number of fly species is probably many times more than this. Many species of flies are cool and cold adapted, and the relative abundance of diptera in the total insect fauna is higher in northern countries such as Canada than in the world as a whole. In high Arctic sites, the number of fly species is greater than that of all other insects. The astounding success of flies is owing to their great versatility in the exploration of habitats and their ability to utilize every possible sort of food. The larvae of the earliest flies probably feed on damp, decaying plant materials, a ubiquitous food source over much of the earth. Flies then colonized both wetter and drier habitats, leading to life in aquatic and terrestrial environments. Many are predators, parasites, and parasitoids, feeding on everything from microscopic animals to mammals. Many eat decaying organic matter and plant materials, and unlike the adult stages of many beetles and bugs, adult diptera have not successfully colonized underwater habitats, but may aquatic or semi-aquatic larvae are common in fly families. They live from the intertidal waters of the ocean shores to the salt encrusted margins of desert alkaline lakes, from rushing glacial torrents to the bottom of deep lakes. Many of these larvae, such as those of mosquitoes, horse flies, and soldier flies, breathe atmospheric air through open spiracles and must come to the surface periodically. Others, such as chronomite midges and black flies, take oxygen from the water through their integument. Still, others live in wet mud or sand or under thin films of water. Those groups, mostly in the higher diptera, that evolved towards dried habitats, live in soil and sand, in leaf, litter, under bark, in wood and fungi, in decomposing material or inside growing plant tissues such as roots, stems, fruits and leaves. Some live as ectoparasites on the skin of vertebrates. Adult flies feed on a wide variety of substances, though some have non-functional mouthparts and do not feed as adults. Most eat liquid food, water, decomposing organic matter, animal and plant secretions such as insect honeydew, flower nectar, animal tissues, fluids including vertebrate blood, soluble solids liquefied by saliva. Flies are ubiquitous and are abundant in individuals as well as in species number. They are important food for other animals. Many are parasitic or predatory on other insects and help keep their populations under control. Some herbivorous flies have been successfully used to control weeds. Many are probably important pollinators of plants. Many are invaluable as scavengers and are vital in aiding in never-ending decomposition of plant and animal material. The flies of Drosophila readily rise in the laboratory and sporting huge salivary chromosomes, providing much of our early understanding of genetics. On the negative side of the ledger, flies are famous. They are far and away the most important insects vectoring diseases in humans and domesticated animals. Blood-sucking flies transmit many diseases including malaria, yellow fever, filariasis, leishmaniasis, and sleeping sickness. Some flies are important pests of crops. Tapeworm fruit flies are serious pests of fruit, leaf miners, stem borers, and other flies destroy our garden plants and crops. Coming to the eggs of dipterans, adults lay eggs usually where larval food is plentiful. Eggs may hatch quickly or go through a period of dormancy. Most of vermiform, that is worm-like maggots with no legs, no prolegs, no wings, no wing buds, and often lacking eyes and a discernible head. They are narrower at the head and broader at the rear. Mouth parts are reduced to two hooks with which they bite. They are considered to have chewing mouth parts. The larvae of mosquitoes are called wigglers. They are aquatic and have a distinct head, prominent eyes and jaws that can chew. All diptera have a pupal stage during which the adult winged form develops. Some pupae are in a silk cocoon. Others remain inside the hardened larval skin, that is cochorate pupa. When the adult emerges from the pupa, it has wings, is fully grown and fully developed, and hooks completely different from the larva. All except a few wingless species have only one pair of membranous wings. Thus, the name diptera meaning two wings. The fore wings are fully developed and functional, while the hind wings are reduced to knobbed clubs called halters, which are difficult to see without magnification except for larger specimens, example crane flies. They are the best flyers in the insect world and possibly beyond. They can hover, fly backwards and upside down and turn on the spot. The order Diptera comprises two main suborders. Nematicera have long legs, long antennae and look fragile, example mosquitoes, gants and midges, etc. While Brachycera have stout bodies and short stout antennae, example horse flies, house flies, robber flies, hover flies, etc. Coming to the damage caused by the dipteran insects. Damage to plants is usually by the larvae which feed inside plant tissue as leaf miners. Borers are gall marks. Adults feed on liquids and usually sugar in the form of nectar or honeydew, feces or blood, or do not feed at all. The primary damage to people and livestock is as biting pests and as a disease vectors. They are carry malaria, yellow fever, dengue fever, St. Louis elephantiasis, West Nile virus, etc. Their mouth parts are varied and highly specialized. Some Nematocera adults, example mosquitoes, have sabbing, siphoning mouth parts. The lower lip of the most Brachycera adults is enlarged and sponge-like. The common house fly and certain other flies split on their food to liquefy it, then spoon it up. Others such as horse flies and deer flies also have scissor-like mandibles, while still others such as table flies also have toothed mouth parts that cut the skin of their prey. No adult fly chews its food. The larvae have mouth hooks that tear plant and animal tissues and is considered a chewing mouth part. Mosquito wigglers also chew their prey. Coming to the conclusion, dipterans are the one of the largest family in the insect world, comprising of 14%. Not only that, they are parasite on some of the agricultural insects like silkworms, thereby causing the damage. Not only that, they will also act as a vectors causing diseases in humans and animals. Thank you.